Imagine you're out fishing one day. Suddenly, you find yourself in the middle of the ocean without food, drink, or shelter. And to make matters worse, a giant whale has attacked your ship. How will you handle this situation? Today we are going to tell the story of this movie in the heart of the sea.
The movie begins in the year 1850, when the oil extracted from the whale was used to light cities and homes. At that time, there were fishermen whose mission was to hunt whales and extract oil from them for later use and daily needs. At that time, there was a person named Melville who left the city to meet another person named Thomas so that he could hear from him the story of the ship that sank in the sea because of a giant whale that attacked it. But Thomas was secretive and isolated and did not want to talk about the matter, although he was the only survivor of that ship. The rest of the members drowned or died. The important thing is that Melville decides to leave because Thomas refused to tell him the story. But Thomas's wife insists on telling him about it, because revealing everything is the way to ease his conscience, and because they needed the money that Melville had. And here Thomas decides to tell the story.
Thomas began telling his story in the 1820s, saying that it was used by people in the whale oil trade. And this example showed, and they used in the use of these pictures the name of the whaling company. It was a whaling company, and obviously this company was made for the trade of whale oil, and tell the owner of the company Owen, because they are sobbing and informing us that we will send you to hire ahead because they are attached to that and that you it'll be a ship next time, but they both take back their words and that they were unnamed, argue with you next time. Then it turns out that Owen was preparing to set sail, and she wasn't Owen's wife. That's why he's known as, gets a prize, gets a passport in his place, and then the whalers rally in his place. It appears that the squawk is still in use, as is the case for the cars, and so are the cars and their organizations after this cubit. This led to the jets blundering, with the jets driving behind, and the jets trailing behind, which required him to use his skills. You must have made him come with you in the morning, and he made sure he made a decision with you at night. A threat of one of the attacks has been placed on the plane. The ship of ships is sailing in the sea storm is a ship as soon as possible. The sea storm, and after threatening him and destroying the warships, chased after him, his table. George explains that he is trying to get the situation out of the way by visiting them, because this is the attitude of the people waiting that we'll be back while taking the oil with us, and Owens convinces George to come here. Owen begins to get a number of whales that they are selling on a ship, Owen a whale, and then begins to get, because they pulled the whale aboard in some oil from it, and they have to send someone to the whale because of how small it was several days ago. Thomas tells that it was an incident like this in my life that changed me. Now Thomas started telling his story in the year 1820. It is the time when the whale was caught in the sea because it was a rare oil that was mostly used by people for the whale oil trade. It was not on ordinary grounds among them, but people were fond of crying and extracting oil, so people used to gamble on it which ship would get more oil among the sailing ships in the sea, and someone showed her name Owen. Owen, who used it to serve a company he also had a wife, it means he was satisfied with his life. It was a whaling company that Owen used to serve for, and this company was obviously made for the trade of whale oil, Owen's meat. And the owner of the company told Owen they are sailing a very expensive ship at sea for they are whaling and telling us we will send you to hire a head sheep, knowing that Owens is confused because they promised that and that you will be the captain of the ship next time, but they took back their words because they were hiring a captain for someone else and it was expected that the name of the captain was George. In fact, George was the son of the owner of the company, and the whaler promised again that Owen would hire him as a captain next time. Oh, and the wages have been increased because of his abilities, so Owen agrees with them and tells them that you will sign a contract that you will hire me as a captain next time. And then it turns out that Owen was preparing to sail, and Owen's wife was not satisfied about his leaving. She says to Owen, promise me you'll be back soon. Owen's allies make him Owen's wife, puts it on the locket, so Owen remembers his promise. After that same boy George, who was the captain there also, George's father tells him his father, go my son and come back after he gets the victory. Then all the whalers gather in a place, there's a crowd of towns to send them all. There's a little boy named Thomas also showed up, yeah, he's a young storyteller who's grown up now. Thomas, who's been out on the sea hunting whales for the first time, Owen's childhood friend was in the ship with other friends after this Captain George, and he never met here. One starts conflict between them because George was holding heavy hand on Owen as captain, but Owen could not take any action as a follower because George was captain. Then they set sail and ship they created sailing problem. At a distance it looked like ship trap. also showed up. Yeah, he's a young storyteller who's grown up now. Thomas, who's been out on the sea hunting whales for the first time. Owen's childhood friend was in the ship with other friends after this. Captain George and he never met here. One starts conflict between them because George was holding heavy hand on Owen as captain, but Owen could not take any action as a follower because George was captain. Then they set sail and ship. They created sailing problem. At a distance it looked like ship trap. But Owen produces the dangerous situation by using his skills. Owen was obviously able to do this because he had experience, that Captain George was quite the opposite, meaning he wasn't as skilled and capable. So he feels the twins are envious who witnessed such skills to Owen. So he picks on M of Quan at the dining table at night. George, Owen's degrade so much because you're Lyman, and that Owen's ex-son couldn't stand that humiliation. So he couldn't take any action, so he left from there saying to his buddies, we'll have to get it early in the morning. And he, it was noted on board that ship Lyman was averting there. They were considered the next day less than George against orders. Owen knows Owen had to carry out George's orders reluctantly. Then Owen saw a storm at sea, shared it with George that there is a storm at sea ahead that is a threat ours, therefore we must retreat our ship. Those against Owen's orders, George to sail the ship in the sea storm, sail in the sea storm. They catch them, Owen shouting also in the sea storm, the ship must retreat as soon as possible. But George has been showing his delusions so far and making the ship sail in the sea storm. And there was a threat to their lives and the destruction of ships anyway. Get out of the storm after ordering George. Owen to apologize to me before all, and we will sail our ship towards our island. It means we will retreat without crying, but Owen does his best. Explain George that the look is trying to make sense of the situation. We can't go back empty-handed because it's about so many lives waiting for us that we'll come back while taking the oil with us, and Owen's here convinces George of that. They pulled the whale onto the ship and started to extract oil from it, and they have to send someone to the whale so that they can send Thomas to the whale because of how small it was several days ago. From fishing now they had no more fishing, and the biggest problem with this bad started being lack of edible things. They stuck on an island in the sea for not sailing there. They made a captain who also came there for whaling. They all meet that man and he tells the last story of his hunting. He tells that we had reached in the heart of the sea where they encounter the biggest whale in the sea, and that whale was the tallest and biggest, which has been named Great Whale. Put Great Whale attacks their ship, which left their ship destroyed. A fracture, the one hand and an arm of the captain and his rest of the companion were also dead, but they don't take it seriously, thinking he is fabricating a story. So that's happened. Leaves from there, but now they have become covetous that they should say no to that part of the sea where the great whale is present. After this they sail ahead to reach that part of the sea. Then the story takes place in the time exactly after 14 months after a great voyage. They finally reach in the part of the sea which was told to them by captain, and great whale was also there. They all sail there taking their weapons and boasts. They are still stay ahead that Owen's boat is attacked by someone. Consequently they fall into the water from the boat at the first time. They witnessed a great whale there. This whale was the same according to the told story by the captain. Then great whale began to leave, but Owen's companions for still seated in the boat getting a chance. They attack one of the whales. They are able to win the whale, but the great whale notices them for doing so, so it directly attacks their ship moving there. As a result ship begins to sink. They attack one of the whales. They are able to win the whale, but the great whale notices them for doing so, so it directly attacks their ship moving there. As a result ship begins to sink. George was also observing this, sitting in the boat leaving that whales there. He starts moving to a ship. George commands everyone to leave the ship soon because it was going to sink. They all inbox the boats now, and they get the edible things which they found by chance in the following morning. It seems that they were observing the sea map, but it had become tough road to hoe because they that again caught in a sea storm. In the sea storm Owen's childhood friend is also badly injured. Now the time begins to pass and Owen used to assist his wounded friends while Owen's rest of the companions were just taking him as a burden, otherwise nothing else. Then the story takes place after 1 month where their edible things had also been ended. They were nearly to die while facing the worst condition. Then their companions Glenn sizzle and being satisfied they begin to sail towards that land. Owen feels something when they are going to reach the shore.